This is me back in my college days. And this is my roommate, Mark. Together, we founded Facebook in 2004. Now, 15 years later, I think Facebook has grown too big and too powerful. Every week brings new headlines about privacy violations, election interference, or mental health concerns. I haven't been at the company in over a decade, but I feel a sense of responsibility to account for the damage done. Americans have the power to right the ship through government action. We need new regulations. It's time to break up Facebook. The early days of Facebook tell a classic American story of innovation and entrepreneurship. From our college dorm room, we started a little social network for our friends that exploded in popularity and connected the world. Mark's hustle in those early years made it possible for Facebook to dominate our rivals, like Friendster, MySpace, Tumblr, and many others. These competitors made us better, and then we beat them out. This is how it's supposed to work in America. Hard work leads to economic success. You start a small business and compete on the merits to provide a better product. Today, nearly 3 billion people use Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp, and they're all owned and controlled by the same company. Of every dollar spent buying ads on social media, 84 cents goes to Facebook. It's now worth over $500 billion. That's roughly the size of the GDP of the bottom 65 countries in the world combined. It's not just that Facebook is a really big social network, it's everything. When a single company dominates any market, they become susceptible to abusing their power. Social networking is like most other American industries. There used to be plenty of healthy competition, but now many industries are controlled by just one or two companies. Companies often create an illusion of choice. You think there are hundreds of beer brands out there, but they're all made by one or two companies. Why is this a problem? Well, when companies get too big, they get sloppy and careless. And that leads to things like poor privacy practices, enabling foreign actors to meddle in elections, the spread of violent rhetoric, fake news, and the unbounded drive to capture more of our data and attention. I often hear people say, "I'm shutting down my Facebook account. Thank God for Instagram." Not realizing that Instagram is owned by Facebook. People are powerless in this situation because there's nowhere else to go. Monopolies stifle innovation. Facebook snatches up competitors by buying them before they get too big, or by copying their innovations. Despite all the money and hype being poured into new startups, there hasn't been a single major social media platform launched since 2011. The harm goes beyond the economy, though. It goes to democracy itself. When companies become empires, people are stripped of power. Facebook's employees write complex rules called algorithms that decide what you see in your newsfeed. Facebook can decide what messages get delivered and which don't, and what exactly makes for violent or inappropriate content. Even Mark himself has said that he and the Facebook team have too much power over speech. Facebook does have a board of directors, but Mark owns the majority of the shares. Unlike the leader of a democracy, there are no checks and balances on Facebook. Mark has no boss, and he cannot be fired. Listen, it'd be great if Mark could fix this himself, but this, ironically, is a problem he cannot solve. We need the government to intervene with two steps. First, the Facebook empire needs to be broken up. America's regulated corporate empires before, and we can do it again. This isn't unprecedented. And surprisingly, it often boosts the value of these companies in the long run. Federal Trade Commission can force Facebook to unwind its acquisitions of WhatsApp and Instagram. Then we'll see real competition around social media and digital messaging. Breaking up Facebook isn't a punishment for its economic success. It's a way to guarantee that other new companies can compete. We also need a new government agency to protect Americans from the overreach of Facebook and other companies like it. Think about it. We don't trust airlines or pharmaceutical companies to regulate themselves, and we shouldn't trust social media companies either. We need basic privacy protections and the ability for people to move their data around as they please. Right now, Facebook makes free speech decisions on its own with little accountability. Instead, we need government to set guidelines, not Facebook employees in Menlo Park. I don't think Mark's a bad guy. And I've made this decision to speak out because I feel a sense of responsibility for what Facebook has become. And to be honest, I'm angry that Mark's obsession with growth led him to sacrifice security for clicks. I think we all want to live in a country where David can take on Goliath, where a kid with a smart idea in a dorm room can start a billion-dollar company. We've strayed from that ideal, and breaking up and regulating Facebook will help put us back on that path.